Walleye are a popular sport fish in New York State. It is believed that walleye were not originally found in Honeoye Lake. However, populations have been sustained through ongoing stocking efforts that date back to the early 1800s. The New York State Department of Environmental Conservation has maintained a stocking program in Honeoye Lake because of the lack of successful natural reproduction. FLCC became involved in the walleye stocking program after acquiring the Muller Field Station in 2000. At the time, there were only anecdotal reports of walleye spawning in the Honeoye Inlet Channel. Springtime FLCC netting confirmed a walleye spawning run in the Honeoye Inlet Channel. Research into the natural history of walleye suggests that the walleye were unable to successfully reproduce in Honeoye Lake because of the lack of appropriate spawning habitat. The New York State DEC operates only one walleye culture facility located on Oneida Lake. FLCC sought out a partnership with the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation to take advantage of the walleye spawning run in the Honeoye Inlet Channel by establishing a walleye culture facility at the Muller Field Station, which supplements walleye stocking in Honeoye and Canisius Lakes. In 2003, the walleye culture facility was operational. Since that time, FLCC faculty and students have successfully operated the walleye culture facility during the spring walleye spawning season. The walleye culture facility allows FLCC faculty and students to bridge a critical gap between poor spawning habitat and good lake environment. The adult walleye are willing and able to spawn, and evidence suggests that the walleye try to spawn each year. Walleye broadcast spawn their eggs over the bottom substrate of streams. Ideally, the eggs would land on a hard substrate surface, such as rock or gravel. But in the Honeoye Inlet Channel, the eggs land on mud and do not survive. In addition to supporting walleye populations in Honeoye Lake, the primary focus of FLCC's fish culture facility is to train FLCC students using state-level fish culture processes and techniques to ensure that students have the experience for future employment in a fish culture facility. Immediately following ice out on the inlet in the spring, adult walleye swim up the Honeoye Inlet Channel to spawn. The electrofishing boat is used to capture the broodstock every day over a two-week period, capturing several hundred adult walleye in a typical year. The electrofishing boat distributes a low amperage field of electricity to momentarily stun the fish so the walleye can be netted by students and transferred into holding tanks on the electrofishing boat. The majority of the walleye netted are between 15 and 22 inches in length. Walleye are transferred to a holding tank and transported up to the fish culture facility where students work up the fish. The workup process includes measuring each walleye for length, determining the sex of the walleye, and determining whether the walleye are ripe. By applying light pressure to the abdomen of the adult walleye, fish will express gametes, indicating that they are ripe for spawning. Students then collect scale samples to age the walleye. Female walleye generally reach sexual maturity at age 3 at about 18 inches in length, while males typically reach sexual maturity at age 2 and are typically 14 inches in length. All walleye are marked by punching a hole in the tail fin to determine future recapture rates. Males and females are then separated into the spawning trough. Eggs are stripped from the females into a plastic bowl. Milt is stripped from the males into the same bowl to fertilize the eggs. Several males are used to fertilize the eggs from each female to promote genetic diversity. Constant mixing is required to prevent the adhesive eggs from clumping. Water is then added to activate the eggs and sperm cells, and fertilization occurs almost immediately. In the wild, it is estimated that less than 1% of the eggs that are released will be fertilized, which is typical for broadcast spawners. Through the walleye culture process, fertilization rates of more than 90% are achieved. This helps bridge the gap of very low fertilization rates in the wild and ensures that the reproduction potential of the walleye is maximized. To continue the spawning process, the fertilized eggs are treated with a tannic acid solution, commonly called mucking, to remove the adhesive properties of the exterior of the eggs. While this adhesive quality is beneficial in the wild, it is detrimental in the culture facility because it promotes clumping, which causes high mortality. Eggs are rinsed of the tannic acid solution and placed into a dilute iodophore solution for disinfection and water hardening. During this hour-long process, the eggs will absorb water and increase in size. To determine the number of eggs spawned, Students count the number of hardened eggs in a single row along a 6-inch trough. This number equates to the estimated number of eggs per quart. The eggs are then placed into calibrated upwelling or McDonald jars, and the total number of quarts of eggs is determined. The McDonald jar is then placed in the incubator, and a water supply tube is inserted into the center of the jar, providing the upwelling of water for incubation. The flow is adjusted for constant movement of eggs at roughly 1 to 2 gallons per minute. Each jar can hold about 4 quarts of eggs. Egg development is governed by water temperature. The early spring walleye spawning run has become the focus of the Muller Field Station spring open house, which is held in early April each year. During the open house, an electrofishing demonstration of the Hunyoy Inlet Channel is led by FLCC students and faculty, and if the walleye are spawning, the public has the opportunity to participate in the workup of the fish in the walleye culture facility. Early spring is also a great time for visiting high school science classes to see the walleye culture facility fully operational. Since 2003, FLCC faculty, staff, and students have captured many hundreds of walleye and successfully hatched millions of eggs. The students learn from a hands-on process that follows state protocol and provides them with employable skills in the field of fish culture. We are extremely proud of the high-quality training FLCC students receive in the fish culture process and the benefit their training provides back to the walleye fisheries in Hunyoy and Canisius Lakes.